Hey, this is Steven. I'm hanging out here with Patrick Dean, one of Athens' best cartoonists here. What's going on, Patrick?
Not much. It's Sunday afternoon.
Yeah, exactly. Well, thanks for having us here today. I just kind of wanted to catch up with you a little bit and see what's going on.
You're welcome.
Yeah. So how long have you been cartooning?
I guess I've been cartooning since I was a really little kid, ever since I first learned how to pick up a pencil and started sketching and doodling and growing up on a good diet of Hulk comics and that sort of thing in early childhood. And, I guess I drew comics throughout high school and that sort of thing. Throughout college, I went through the brief. Okay, I only want to be a serious artist for a while. So I actually didn't do a heck of a lot of cartooning for about 2 or 3 years there for a while. Then picked it back up towards the end of college when I went into graphic design.
Nice. How did your relationship with Flagpole start?
I guess it started sometime around like 96 or 97 when I just kind of picked up one and realized that they didn't have any local, cartoonist in there anymore. They used to be for a while, they'd be like 3 or 4 in there every week. So I just went to them one day with a stack of, comics I had done and said, would you all be interested in these? And I think Richard Fawcett had just started becoming editor there and hired me immediately. So, I think the first two comics were called True Athens Stories. That turned into me telling a story about how someone I knew from high school had an obsession with Michael Stipe. And she wound up, going to his house, hanging out there for a while. He wasn't there, but then a water cooler delivery person showed up and put like a water cooler and the bill on the doorsteps. And she kind of walked up there and just took the water bill off the doorsteps. I think she probably still has it 10 years later, but it's like a little water bill invoice to, Michael Stipe framed on the wall.
Yeah.
Or the weirdest piece of music memorabilia or something.
So besides Flagpole, what else have you been published in?
I've also been published in an anthology called Legal Action Comics Mini Comics Anthologies, such as Study Group 12 and our own Fluke anthology books that have been put out here and there.
So. Yeah. And Fluke, that's something that's local here to Athens, right? And they do every year. Tell me a little bit about that.
Sort of a thing that we've all got together where we're trying to attract a lot of local cartoonists and stuff to kind of put together a big anthology of comics and kind of discovering, okay, who all in Athens draws comics besides us, It's kind of a nice way to kind of get the people out who are doing stuff, local stuff, and bring them forward and, getting your stuff published and, recognized. I think our first year, we barely broke even with, having 50 people show up. And then the next year was like between 50 and 80. And then I think this year we had about over 100 people show up.
Yeah.
And we were really excited. We had Sam Henderson show up.
And I understand he's got some affiliation with Nickelodeon. And
he does. He's he's a writer for SpongeBob, and that really worked out really well. And he was actually impressed with. I think he said he sold more stuff here than he does a really big comic book convention. It was a very positive experience. So.
Yeah, your cartoons, by some, have been saying they're bizarre, esoteric. How would you describe your own stuff, or paint a picture, if you will, for us about kind of your style and how your creative process works?
That's kind of difficult. I mean, to some degree, I wouldn't necessarily call what I do really, wacky or bizarre. I mean, sometimes the cartoons I do are just kind of goofy or out there. But I think it always is kind of funny when some of the people just kind of get, I don't want to say angry, but just kind of look at it and just get so confused. They're like, oh, what is this? Doesn't make any sense. That's not funny. We're just kind of oddball, bizarre. I mean, it's not, I don't necessarily out there trying to shock people or do anything really avant-garde or anything.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just more of a, just trying to make people laugh. Recently, I started doing a longer story that I've gotten up to about 40 pages on, and I'm like in the midway of that, and it's kind of a lot more fun doing a story that's, more than just 3 or 4 panels long.
We've got quite a collection of old kind of figures over here. Can you kind of take us on a tour of this?
Most of it's either stuff from my childhood or stuff that I just, pick up at garage sales. I mean, I have like, my childhood Transformers that kind of came out of my parents' house after they said, get the stuff out of here, Childhood Hulk toys or stuff I've picked up at flea markets here and there, and I think it's kind of a prerequisite of being a cartoonist. You got to have like the 1 or 2 crowded bookshelves full of crap.
So who are some of your favorite cartoonists or different artists that you think maybe someone like me might know about?
Maybe Jack Davis, someone who worked for UGA, but also prior to that worked for EC in the early 50s, drawing some of the early Mad Comics with Harvey Kurtzman, who edited the book at the time. And Jack Kirby, one of the early artists who had been working since the 30s and did all the Marvel comics in the 60s.
Yeah.
Steve Ditko, who is known for drawing gorgeous hands. He did these really great expressive hands and really dark shadowing stuff.
Yeah.
It's just great to look back at these artists who also used to work on such a tight deadline that, it was said that Jack Davis could, do a 6 to 7 page story in 3 days.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's almost unheard of now.
Mm-hmm.
So it kind of makes me want to not complain when I have a week deadline to do 6 panels. And basically not want to complain about that, but be more inspired to work harder and work faster.
Mm-hmm. What's next on the horizon?
I'm putting out the 5th issue of Big Deal Comics and Stories, where I'm going to be starting a 4-issue mm-hmm. story arc with a new story that I'm doing called Trogiston, which is this huge sort of longer story.
Well, thanks a lot for having us in your house, Patrick. We'll make sure we'll keep an eye out for Big Deal. And this is How We Roll.